becoming fun, especially math. Math's not just about numbers, equations, calculations, or even algorithms. It's about understanding and applying what we learn to real-life situations. That's why we don't just learn from the textbook, we also learn through activities and fun problems. Now let's see how each grader Casey learns math.
Hi friends, my name is Aryan. I'm going to do some counting and some arithmetic. Friends, this is the number 4. 4. Bye friends, see you next week.
Hi, my name is Zua. I'm going to show you how to roll the dice. I got 6 lots of pick. 6 drop card and another 6 card. Bye.
Hello everyone. I'm going to sort out everything. And it's spoon and it's spoons, forks and straws. And look at and I'll sort it out right now. So this pattern is straws, spoons, forks.
Hello everyone. I'm going to do a pattern. Come, I will show you. Spoon. Fork. Pum pum.
I am going to measure my 2 kitchen with my block. Let's see the big kitchen first. 1, 2. So my small kitchen is 6 blocks tall. So my big kitchen is 7 blocks tall. This is the tallest kitchen. And these blocks are not standard units.
Hello everybody, my name is Alexa Nathiel. So, today I'm going to tell you about crocodile mouth. So, I have a crocodile mouth. It eats only the bigger number, not small number.
Why?
Because he's very hungry, like this. Wah!
Okay.
So, now I'm going to put here 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm going to keep here 1. So what will a crocodile mouth eat? Which one? This? Okay, it will eat this one because it's bigger. Thank you.
Okay. Hi auntie. What is a multiplicator? It is when something is half and same, like my foam shapes. See my Geo board? I made shapes, then the line, now both sides are same. Bye, auntie.
Adithalam is 8 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Auntie has taught me how to see the time, so now I'm really good at it. So now I can join all my online classes on time.
And here's a fun math. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 2, 22.
Math is my favorite class. I love to find out activities we do to learn different things.
In math, we use combinations. In darts, when you play, you are 50 and 30. So then that means 80 points.
Hello everyone, this is Vivian Vijwick from Adventurers of Leaping Lions. Now I'm going to talk about my favorite concept in math, which is cups. The strategy which I follow is circle the numbers, underline the keyword, plan your strategy, solve and check. That's it. It gives a solution easily for any problem. Thank you all. Bye.
Math in KCI is fun because we put fun into our math. Like when we had our array homework, we were supposed to go around our houses and search for arrays. It was really, really fun. And I also realized that math is like connected to different subjects. After my angle homework, I did my social homework on my Lego Shandolph. And then I realized that it has so many angles and I figured it out. That's why I think that if teachers teach the same way we do in KCI, math will be more fun and less boring.
We were learning about decimals and created a decimal artwork. We got a 100 square box and treated it with different colors. If I treated 10 squares pink, the fraction will be 10 out of 100 and the decimal will be 0.1.
The problem of the week is fun and challenging. The problem of the week makes us think hard and use different math concepts. We don't only write the answer, but we also write the steps and how we arrived at it.
We GGs use escape room to learn mental math. Suppose if I type a wrong code, it takes me to the wrong code slide. And if I type the right code, it allows me to go to the next room.
Hi, I'm Samara from grade 5. Today I'm going to tell you how we made number clues through Google Sites. We thought of a number, we listed the clues, we put them in Google Sites, published the Google Sites, copied the taskbar link and pasted it in the Google Slides that you gave us, chose three people that could solve our clues. It was quite fun because we could make questions for the others and we could solve theirs. So some of the questions included if it was an even number, prime number, if it was between this number, that number, or how many digits. So it was really fun.
One of the activities we did in decimals was this. This activity helps us add and group whole numbers and also teaches us a little about the number system.
Hi, my favorite topic in math was coordinates. So in coordinates, this was one of our first tasks. So the black one was the original one and the red one was the reflection. So we did this completely by our own after listening to Auntie's instructions. And we moved on to much more fun games related to coordinates. Thank you.
Oh, hello there. I didn't see you. Well, let me introduce you to grade 6 blended learning. My favorite topic out of all has to be fractions. Well, I remember starting off with watching videos, doing Khan Academies, challenging ourselves with challenging questions, and also there's a twist. We did chocolate ball making in class with the professional baker on board. How fun is that? Quantity of all the fractions by hand, converting grams to cups. And most importantly, it has been such a memorable and fun experience to me. Remember, even if you're farther away from physically, remember that we are learning every heart by heart, every single day.
Hello everyone. Without online tools like GeoGebra, math would have been a struggle for us this year, especially geometry. But we can use GeoGebra to draw shapes, learn functions, plot coordinates, and even draw graphs like that. GeoGebra also has a ton of practice questions that we can attempt.
We have been using Khan Academy as a major online tool this academic year. The content in Khan Academy is short, fun, and interactive, and presented through videos and quizzes. We can do the work at our own pace, as and when the teachers assign it to us. There's also a sense of accountability when we complete the work.
My name is Madhav and I'm in grade 9, and the way we do maths at grade 9 is quite unique. We learn to approach problems from different methods. We learn to approach it algebraically, numerically, and graphically. And it's quite beautiful and elegant to see how these various different methods of varying usefulness and varying efficiency actually converge to give you the right answer. We're essentially peeling away the layers of abstraction within the question to ultimately give us the right answer. And it's quite cool as to how we can apply the various tools that we develop in maths classes to actually solve these fairly tricky problems.
Hi, I'm Anushka from grade 10. In our maths class, we learn about a variety of concepts. The teacher starts the lesson with a short introduction to the topic, and then we are encouraged to work at our own pace. In investigative math, we work on finding patterns between sets of numbers. This helps us solidify our real-world applications as well as connect different concepts that we learn in regular math class.
Math at the IB Diploma program at KC is more than just analyzing sums and solving equations. The IA is an independent research study that each student takes up. This helps us dive into our subject deeper and explore our area of interest mathematically. This also helps us realize that there's as much math outside the classroom as there is inside.
Finally, you think, after all of this, what's the point of maths? Maths is either love or hate. You absolutely hate it or you really love it. Maths is an integral, added and very important part in our universe. It's there from in the cricket field I'm standing in to the plane that's just flying over. It's there everywhere. That's why, that's the point of maths. That's why maths cannot be escaped from and you can't live without maths. From your date of birth to your last day on earth, maths will be with you everywhere. As they say, your breaths are numbered.